Hi everybody! Having fisheyes in the first layer of epoxy is probably one of the most common problems when it comes to epoxy coating your lures. In this little video log, I'll show you how you can prevent some of these fisheyes from ruining the lure and the final product. Okay, just hang in here. Yesterday I gave a bunch of lure the first layers of epoxy. And today I just noticed that one of the lures had a very deep fisheye. One of those fisheyes that goes all the way into the lure body and actually a millimeter around some sort of dust particle sitting there in the paint. I could try to remove that particle, which is probably the one causing the fisheye, but I'm afraid I'll just damage the paint job, so I won't do that and I don't really have to. Okay, well, I'm just going to make a little drawing here to clarify what the problem is and how I'm going to solve it. Well, if you have the lure body here, and I have some sort of a tiny dust fragment here, which is something that the epoxy doesn't really like. So what happens is that when you apply a coat of epoxy, you'll end up with epoxy lying on the lure like this, going away from that point. And that will happen even after you try to apply the second layer. The hole might be smaller, but it will still happen. And even after a few layers, well, the hole might be closed, but it'll still leave kind of a lumpy surface. So what you need to do is to close that, that cavity here. And for that purpose, I'm going to use some UV resin. And I'm just going to apply a tiny drop of that, trying to fill this void here. Then I'm just going to harden it with the UV light source. And once it's hardened, I can give it the next layer. There might be some small areas here which is kind of lower than the rest, but the next layer of epoxy actually usually fills those out very easily. And at least maybe they give you a little bit more here, and then after the third layer you'll have a completely nice layer. Okay, so this is what we're going to do. First of all, I'll just grab a clean piece of paper towel here to put on the table and make sure that I don't get any other dust fragments on my lure while working on it. And I'm just going to place my lure on that one. And then grab my UV resin here and apply a tiny little drop of that to the exact fisheye here. Like that, and that was way too much, so I'll just remove some of it. Okay, and now it looks like it's more or less in level with the rest of the lure here. And then it's just a question of hardening the UV resin with your light source here. And I usually give them a little extra time to make sure that it's completely hardened, because once you apply the next layer of epoxy, well, it's completely sealed, and I would want it to be hardened at that point. Of course, it being UV resin, it will harden afterwards once the lure is outside anyway. One thing that the UV resin is also good at is if you're applying 3D eyes to your lures, you really don't want them to be too loose, so when you're applying the epoxy they start sliding around, and UV resin will quickly fixate those, just a drop and a little bit of light, and you will make sure that the I stay in place. But that's another thing. Okay, I'll just leave it here for maybe 15 minutes, 30 minutes. It's a bit more than needed probably, but then I'm sure it's completely hardened. And then I'll just get on with the second layer over here, and in the end I'll just show you the result. Here after the second layer of epoxy, I must say that the fish eye is more or less completely gone. If it wasn't because I knew that there has been something there, I wouldn't have noticed at all. As you can see from these recordings, well, the surface is really more or less completely smooth. Still, I want to just add a third layer, as I always do on these baits, and in the end I'll just show you the final result, okay? The lure has now had its third layer of epoxy, and as you can see from these recordings, all traces of the fisheye has gone. So this really is a good way to get rid of those deep, nasty fisheyes. Okay? If you have more or many on a lure, maybe it's a little bit hard to use this approach, but for those single deep ones, it's very useful. Of course, it's always a good idea to try to avoid those fisheyes in the first place. And generally, they are caused by handling the lures without gloves on, so you leave tiny traces of grease on it. So never do that, always use gloves. Also, make sure that you are not don't have too much dust in your work area. Even small fragments can cause those nasty fisheyes. Well, I hope you found this little tip useful, and if so, please remember to subscribe to be informed when I release new material. Apart from that, there's nothing left to say, but I hope you see me soon. Thank you. Goodbye.